Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. In addition, if you haven't subscribed to my second channel, The Roddy King, I'm going to include a link up at the top. You can click on that, go over and subscribe to that channel as well. I'll be producing content for The Roddy King very, very soon. All right, guys, let's break down why I chose the Rottweiler over the Bull Mastiff. I know a lot of you guys think that, oh, you just love the Rottweiler and that's why you chose the Rottweiler. From watching this channel, you should understand that I make very pragmatic decisions. I don't just go with my heart, especially when you talk about a dog you're gonna be spending your life with, your family's gonna be spending their life with. I didn't just go with what I felt like or what I liked. I actually did some serious analysis and decided that the Rottweiler was the best breed for me. And that doesn't take anything away from these other breeds. Let me get into what it is that I'm looking, what I was looking for in a dog breed. Natural protector, a great family companion, a generally healthy breed, a large dog breed that was suitable for urban and suburban living, a dog breed that was child friendly, as well as dog friendly, and extremely loyal. And I'll be honest with you, Bull Mastiff really hits the mark if that's what you're looking for. When it came down to me making a call, this was probably the closest. Even though this isn't my second favorite dog breed, it probably finished second in terms of me, you know, once I did an analysis on my life and I did an analysis on the dog breeds, this was probably my second choice. But there were some things that still pushed me in the direction of the Rottweiler. Let's first go over some of the pros, some of the things that I think are advantages that the Bull Mastiff has over the Rottweiler. First of all, they're very gentle. They're low energy, which is a good thing and a bad thing, because that low energy is also going to appear on my cons list as well. They're dog friendly. They're close quarter protector, which means they're like a Velcro dog. The advantage of a dog being very gentle is that I have small children. I don't need a 130-pound roughhouse. They're low energy, which is good as well, because I have a busy life. I don't have time. I don't have a tremendous amount of time to burn off a dog's energy. You know, having a Bull Mastiff probably would free up another 30 minutes to 45 minutes in my day, as opposed to owning a Rottweiler, because they don't necessarily need as much activity and attention. Bull Mastiffs are very friendly. Obviously, you want to socialize them so that they can be very friendly, but they can easily accept dogs, other dogs, and even cats in their life. They're a close quarter protector, which to me is great, because in sports, they always say the best ability is availability. Bull Mastiffs are always going to be beside you. If you're sitting by a window, somebody's coming through the window, you know, you don't have to call your dog to be by your side. Your dog's going to be right there with you, and he's going to be able to engage any threat, or even just as a visual deterrent, he'll be right there. So those are the advantages, and I do feel like, you know, as I'm sitting here right now recording this audio, and my boy Roscoe is like sitting at my feet, I do find that, you know, Rottweilers are a lot more clingier than I thought they were initially. Over the last couple of days, Roscoe has pretty much always been by my side. When I move, he moves. Some of the reason why I didn't choose a Bull Mastiff is because the Bull Mastiff does come with some cons. The biggest con for me is drooling. I visited a lot of homes, and I know for a fact that my wife was not going to go for drool on the walls, drool on the furniture, drool on the floor. That was probably the biggest knock I had against the Bull Mastiff, is that they typically drool a lot more than Rottweilers. Another issue for me was that Bull Mastiffs can be a little sensitive, very emotional dog breed, which, I mean, depending on where you are, can be a good thing. But because I am somewhat busy, I have children, I have a wife, I really don't have the time to deal with an emotionally hurt dog. And I'm not saying that that's really a big issue for Bull Mastiffs, but I will say that Bull Mastiffs are much more sensitive than Rottweilers, and if you get the wrong Bull Mastiff, that could be an issue. As a pro, I had that they were very low energy, but I also had that down as a con, because for me, I do need a dog that will help me be a little bit more active, that will get me out walking a little bit more. And while it would be great to have an extra 45 minutes to do nothing in a day, it probably would be better for me to have an extra 45 minutes of activity in a day. So the low energy thing is a good thing and a bad thing. Depends on where you are in life. If you're somebody a little bit older and you really know, and you're in great shape, or you got a regimen where you're doing your thing at the gym, you know, 3 hours a day, and you don't want to have to, you know, do something, you know, do another hour and a half or hour in a day with your dog, you might want to go with the Bullmaster. It might be better for you. But for me, I enjoy walking, I enjoy hiking, and I would love to do that with it, you know, with my dog. So that's kind of that's how I exercise. Another con that I have for the Bullmaster is that they get a little too big. 120 pounds is about all I really want in a dog. If I can get a little bit smaller, 115, 110 pounds, that would be better for me. You get the right Bullmaster, you get the right genetics, you're easily gonna have 140, 145 pound dog, maybe even bigger. Lastly, I know I said earlier that drooling was probably the biggest knock I had on the Bullmaster. I'm gonna take that back. The fact that this breed is brachycephalic is probably the biggest knock I have on the Bullmaster. Living in Southern California, we have very hot days, and brachycephalic dogs are probably at a disadvantage living in this heat. And with global warming, I know this might be a little political, but with global warming, it's only getting hotter. And, you know, and like I said earlier, I love to go out walking and hiking with my dog. And, you know, I just don't know that a Bullmaster, even for short walks on a lot of days in the calendar year in Southern California, are probably not going to be great days for a Bullmaster to be outside walking. So that, again, is a big knock I have against this otherwise amazing dog breed. Now, I want to just clear this up real quick. Everything I said in this video is my personal opinion. Nothing I'm saying in this video is meant to be objective or academic. These are all my personal views on the different breeds and just basically an explanation of how I got to the Rottweiler. All right, guys, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. If you guys haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Also, check out my channel, The Rottie King. All right, now, peace.